Hello, in this video I am going to explain what semicolons are, these little bad boys right here. So you've probably seen this thinking, what the hell are they? And they're at the end of these two lines, but not the end of other lines. So basically they are to eliminate or, signify the end of an individual statement, an individual line. So this is one self-contained line. This prints out to the console. At the end, you put a semicolon. If I don't, let's see what happens. If I click run, and if I just open this up a bit more, keep doing this. Need to save it first, run it. Okay, so if I have a look now what the error has produced. It says expected semicolon before return. I mean, that's all it's telling you. So the way C++ knows that you're at the end of a line is by having a semicolon, because some languages like Visual Studio Basic, for example, Visual Basic, for example, they know you're on a new line because you've clicked enter and you type in the next bit of code. That's the way it knows. Whereas in C, I might have said C++, sorry, but it's the same principle for both. With C, I could technically do this, run that, okay, one second, let me just clear the console. And there we go, that works fine. So with C and C++, your statements can actually span multiple lines. This is beneficial if you have one really long statement and maybe it goes off screen and you sort of want to format it down. Maybe it takes several parameters and you want to format one on each line, for example. Maybe each one is doing its own calculation as well. So that's the benefit. But then how would the compiler know where the end of that particular statement is? With the semicolon. Same with this return zero statement. This is obviously a very simple one, but every statement has to have a semicolon. The exceptions are stuff with a hash at the start of it. So hash include, hash define, and other preprocessor directives. Other preprocessor directives that I'll cover, in separate videos, don't need semicolons because these are actually triggered and handled before the compiler even hits. And functions don't need it as well, essentially. So this is a function implementation. The way this knows, the way the compiler knows where the function ends is because it has a start brace and an end brace. So that if that end brace was like here, for example, this isn't, the best formatted code. I'll delete this comma because this will mess things up a bit. That's still valid for the simple reason we got semicolons that indicate this ends here. We got a semicolon that indicates this statement ends here. And we got curly braces indicating that this main function starts and ends here. Let me test the beautify feature. The beautify. I thought there was a beautify feature in here. Maybe I was mistaken. I might be thinking of something else that I recently saw. Let me have a look. Right click again. I will just undo everything. There we go. So there's another exception to the semicolon. And technically, it's not an exception because it's still an individual statement. It's when you potentially have another function, for example, say void, I'm going to call it hello. We could have a function, have some code in here. But if we wanted to have this function after the main, but use it in the main, we would need to declare it above. Again, I'm going to cover this in separate videos, but I just wanted to show you the exception. And because this don't have any curly braces, you would have a semicolon. It's still technically a single line statement, so hence the semicolon. So that is it. So that is, the reason for semicolons and the way you use semicolons. Trust me, you're going to come across errors with semicolons throughout your entire programming career. You're going to miss semicolons, you're going to put them where they shouldn't be. And that's going to cause sometimes not even compilation errors, sometimes runtime errors. You're going to, you know, potentially add more than one semicolon. Happens all the time, so don't worry. And okay, it's that simple. If you have any questions, feel free to join the Discord group. There's a link in the description. There's programming channels. There's over 3,700 members. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video.